So guys, what is good? It is your boy Montell Fish here, and we are back with another video talking about fashion. And is it vain? Is art vain? Is just creating in general vain? And I think this is a huge question for a lot of people, specifically me when I first started getting into creating, and definitely just like creating as like putting out Christian art. Because before I like just put out regular art, and I always loved fashion, and I love photography, and I love just like different giftings. But when I became a Christian, I lost focus of like how much of this is vain, how much of this is actually just me wanting to do it, and there's like pride and all this stuff in it. And slowly and slowly, as I've walked on my relationship with God, I've seen like how much is actually being redeemed and how much can be used to glorify God. And so I kind of want to talk about, is fashion vain, is art vain, is just creating vain? And kind of using the example of someone like Kanye West, because I know this is a person hugely that was in fashion and is still in fashion, which has like one of the biggest like shoe brands, which is Yeezy. And he's also a personal like longtime fan of mine, and like since his conversion of coming to Christianity, like I've just been looking out for his new work. I think he's working on a new song called God's Country and working on a new album as well. So I'm not gonna say I completely agree with everything Kanye West does or says, but the mind that God has given him is like out of this world creative to me, and he has like still aspects of like childlike creativity that I admire myself. So I first want to talk about individuality, which is something I preach about endlessly. Just being a person who is themselves, I think, is a beautiful thing. We're like, as people of God, we're called to not be the exact same and the exact replicas. We're called to be walk in unity, but that doesn't mean we're replicates of the next person or the next thing. There's beauty in diversity, and I think we lose that, especially in a lot of America and a lot of cultures. We don't appreciate our differences. We don't appreciate like the fact that I like the color blue and you like the color green, and that's beautiful. Together we can make something blue and green. But rather than that, we say, hey, you need to be like me, or hey, you need to do things exactly like how I do them. And then I think that results in a lot of separating, and then a lot of arts and a lot of people that are like creative like me, who like loves photos and loves fashion, they get pushed to the side and they go to the world and they say, well, the church isn't going to accept me because I'm different and I don't do it like this, so I'm just going to go to the world and create. And that's where a lot of like division happens, and that's where I think the devil wins. But I think when we actually appreciate what makes us different as humans and as Christians, then we actually see growth and value. So individuality is a huge part of just being a well-rounded Christian and understanding what makes you different in the way you dress and the way you talk and where you're from. And it can also help you understand like who the people are that are going to listen to you, because if you're from a certain culture, most likely you're going to go back to that culture and tell them about this Jesus that you know. And when you talk like them and you dress like, you know, you just dress like yourself. You're not even trying to dress like them, but you're just dressing like yourself, and you create art like you create art because God made you to create that way, because he put you there. Then you can easily speak to people. And I'm not confusing this with people who specifically like try to become like the world to win the world. That's a whole nother thing. But it's just being who you are, being who God made you to be, and not being like ashamed of that, not feeling like you have to be like this person, but actually just being you. I think that's where the beauty comes in. Now, I do want to talk about the other side, which is the vain side to it, which is caring about what people think and about having like expensive clothes and expensive money. A lot of the fashion stuff that I get is from thrift stores, and I like silhouettes, and I like focusing on different colors and color palettes, but a lot of the stuff I'm wearing is not any more expensive than a lot of what you guys are wearing. I just wear it differently, and I wear it in my own way. So I think when we actually have this perspective of I'm just wearing what I want to wear because I think it fits me more, not because I'm trying to impress you with expensive clothes and expensive things. I think that's where we should stay as Christians, because it's easy to get caught up in the high fashion and this, when there is good quality things. I'm not disregarding that, and I think it can be okay to have nicer things, but we should also be giving as well. But as a Christian, and as just knowing that line, I always just try to think of like, how much am I caring about people when I'm wearing these things? Like, am I just wearing this because this is something that God has given me to have a passion for and like, or am I wearing this to impress someone? So I think that's a sober perspective to have when we're dealing with issues like this that can seem like gray matters. And even in the issues of art, it's like, I could be a person, and a lot of you guys know me from the music and stuff that God has allowed me to create. I could be a person that just went straightly and created contemporary Christian music because that's what works and that's what it seems like God is using, and that's what, like, it seems like they're doing in the churches. So maybe that's like the most holy thing, and I see all these people like getting slain and getting slain in the spirit and like knowing God through it. But God like allowed me to be different and allow people to be spoken and ministered through a different way. But if I was just to copy that stuff, then you wouldn't have artists like myself and artists like Ecclesia and artists like a lot of my friends that create music that want to be different and want to be called out and set apart, even in the Christian genre. Not to say that there's anything wrong with Hillsong and wrong with these contemporary Christian music, but I think it's beautiful to have a difference. So with all that being said, I think Christians creating art, working in fashion, is something that can be very beautiful and can portray the gospel in such a new way, in such a fresh way, and in ways that the eyes of the world haven't seen before, and the ways that they can come to know God. So I actually want to start doing more fashion stuff on this channel. I think probably next week I'm gonna do like a styling video on how I style some stuff, and just promoting like being yourself and being who God called you to be. So with all that being said, pray for me. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, like, comment, subscribe, comment your thoughts down below. I'd love to just hear what's going through your minds and humble myself and just hear. So thank you guys again. It's your boy Montell Fish. If you do want to follow me and keep up with like my fashion, I post a lot of it on my Instagram at Montell Fish, and also just talk about music and different things that God is doing in my heart, and I just let it be real. I just let it be me. So if you guys want to check that out, please do. But thank you guys for watching. I appreciate all of you, and I'll see you on the next one.